morning students. Today we are going to learn about a class 8th topic, that is chapter 8 of class 8, that is cell structure and functions. So what do you mean by cell? So first of all, I want to clear out that cell is the basic fundamental unit of life. So we need to maintain, to form our body, a basic fundamental unit, that is cell. Our body is made up of cells. As we have already discussed in the before video, that cells are the basic part of our life, and because of cells, the tissues are formed, and because of tissues, organs are formed. Organs comprise to form organ system, and organ system comprise to form an total organism. So now in today's class, we are going to learn that what is the cell and what is the structure and what are the functions in a brief way. So first of all, cell. Cell is discovered by Robert Hooke. Robert Hooke was a scientist. He discovered cell in the year 1665, and what he told is that the cell is the main basic fundamental part of a life. He took an onion peel and done an experiment, and he sees that some of the cell-like structure, a structure like web, and he also took the bark of a tree, and he felt that some wall-like structure, web-like structure being formed, and that a particular circular form, that is a nucleus-like structure present in between the cell. So he told that in all the organisms of our body, whether it is a multicellular or whether it is a unicellular, there are a body basic fundamental part of life, that is cell. So let us understand more briefly about this cell. So in our body, there are different types of cells, because different types of tissues perform different functions. So as we have already known that different tissues have different functions, means they are made up of different types of cells. So what they are, let us consider three types of cells. Here I have written red blood cells, nerve cells and muscle cells. So what are red blood cells? Red blood cells are red in color. They travel in our blood. They carry the oxygen in our blood. They are responsible for carrying oxygen throughout our body. So these different cells are performing different functions. Now let us talk about nerve cells. What is a nerve cell? Nerve cell is nothing but a cell called neuron. Neuron comprised to form a nerve cell, and this nerve cell is responsible for the transfer of messages from our brain to all the body parts. For example, I am moving my hand like this, means my brain has given me the message to do like the action. So whatever action being performed by us is being here decided, and then being the message transferred to the body parts through with the help of a neuron, that are nerve cells. They carry the messages. Now muscle cells. Muscle cells are tough, and they are elongated spindle-like cells, and they are present in our muscles. So they are responsible for the formation of our muscle bones. So these are the three types of cells we have already learned, and we have already learned what are the functions. Now let us talk about, actually in our world, there are two types of organisms present. What are they? First is unicellular, and the second one is multicellular. So what is a unicellular and what is a multicellular? So first of all, let us discuss about unicellular. Unicellular is nothing but a cell, a single cell organism, means an organism made up of only one cell. And what is multicellular? Multicellular is nothing but an organism, a complex body formed, a complex organism made up of many cells. For example, human beings. An example of unicellular is amoeba, leishmania, paramecium. So these are the examples of unicellular. So now let us understand about cell more briefly. For example, now in this class, again I want to tell you, we have already learned that what is cell. But in our organisms, there are two types of mainly organisms. We have talked unicellular and multicellular. And now let us talk about what are the types of organisms present in our body. There are two, plants and animals. So basically, their cells must be different. Plants are having different cells, and animals are also having different cells. So let us talk about what is a plant cell and what is an animal cell. I will show you some little difference between these two cells. For example, if we take a plant cell. Plant cell consists of cell wall, a rigid, tough-like structure inside nucleus. They consist of vacuoles and there are plastids present inside the cell of a plant. But when we talk about the animal cell, there is an absence of cell wall. They are not having the cell wall. So there are lots of differences between these two cells. They are small, small vacuoles present inside the animal body, animal cell body. And there are large, big, big vacuoles present inside a plant body. There is an absence of plastids, absence of chloroplast in an animal cell. And there is the presence of chloroplast in the plant cell. So now there are the three main components of a cell, that is the nucleus, cytoplasm and the cell membrane. So what is a cell membrane? Cell membrane is nothing but a boundary around the cell is the cell membrane. The boundary around the cell is told as cell membrane. And what is the nucleus? The center part of the cell. And nucleus is the main important part of a cell, and it is act as like a mother at our home. Mother is our nucleus of our family. Like that, the nucleus of the cell is nothing but the mother of this particular cell. So this is the nucleus, and the one more main component is the cytoplasm. The cytoplasm is nothing but the jelly-like liquid present inside the cell. So this jelly-like liquid fixes the different types of cell organelles inside the cell. So these are the three main components. What are the three main components? That is the cell membrane, nucleus, and this is the cytoplasm. So in our next class, we will again going to learn more briefly what are these three structures and how many types of cells are already present. Depending upon this cell membrane, depending upon the nuclear membrane, we will going to discuss in our next class.